When you hear the word traffic, what do you think of? Do you think of vehicles passing by on the street? I sure hope not. When it comes to internet marketing, traffic is another word for customers coming to your business. It's the absolute lifeblood of any business, but it's also the number one thing that most businesses struggle with. And if you're on this video right now, then you're probably looking for ways of getting eyeballs to your offer, correct? Well, that's exactly what you will learn about today. In today's video, you will not only learn various methods of driving traffic, but you're also going to learn the massive trap that I fell into so you could avoid making this common mistake. And if you stay till the end, I'm also going to reveal exactly how I began making my first high-ticket sales online. So whether you are completely new and haven't had much success yet, or you're looking for more ways of getting customers in the door, this is the video for you. Without further ado, let's get some traffic. So I want to start this video off by going over the big trap that I fell into when I first got online. So I got online around mid-2017, and for the first 6 months, I was dabbling in a lot of different things. I tried affiliate marketing, dropshipping, freelancing, which I actually did make some pretty decent money with. But overall, I'd say it wasn't until late November 2017 was when I decided to really focus on promoting high-ticket affiliate offers. And so around this time, I joined this biz op that offered digital information products, which allowed you to earn commissions of up to $2,000 per sale. Pretty exciting, right? Now, when I joined this opportunity, I got access to training videos from my sponsor showing me how to promote the system. And the nice thing about this was I was given access to a replicated funnel that I could use, which was proven to work for other members, and all I had to do was get targeted traffic to the funnel, or at least that's what I had thought. Now, the strategy that my sponsor really focused on teaching was something known as solo ads. And if you aren't familiar with what solo ads are, they are basically where you rent out someone else's email list and promote your biz op, training course, software, etc. And as someone who had very little experience or knowledge on how to market online, I was very excited because all I really had to do was buy clicks from a vendor and send it over to my link. This is what I was taught from my sponsor, was to do this every week and let the sales video and email follow-ups do all the explaining. So for the next few months, I would take a portion of my paycheck every week and I would invest in a solo ad, feeling very optimistic, thinking if I do this long enough, I'll eventually be making sales in my sleep. But unfortunately, this was not the case. I was getting lots of traffic, I was generating lots of opt-ins, but none of them were actually buying. And the thing that I found very frustrating was I was seeing all these other members inside the Facebook group, you know, sharing their results like, hey, I just made another $2,000 sale on complete autopilot using your strategy. You know, thanks, man. But then here I was thinking to myself, why am I not getting sales? This is something that really had me feeling frustrated for a very long time. And the entire reason why I had joined this business opportunity in the first place was so that I could quit my job and, you know, be my own boss. But here I thought I was doing everything that I was told, you know, buying traffic, sending it to the funnel, and letting the follow-up emails do, you know, the explaining for me. But I began to wonder, you know, what is it that these people getting results are doing that, you know, I'm not? It looked as though I was following in their footsteps, but I knew there had to be something missing. And it took me a very long time to learn exactly what this missing ingredient was, but after falling on my face for, you know, over and over again for the next 2 years, I finally figured out exactly what I was missing. And once I learned this, I was finally able to start generating commissions just like these. So what is this secret exactly? That's what I'm going to reveal towards the end of this video. But first, let's go over some of the ways that you can get traffic. All right, so as I had kind of already mentioned a bit earlier, solo ads was actually the method that I got started with. And one of the platforms that you could actually use to get solo ads to your offer is with a platform known as Udemy. So this is a very popular marketplace that you could use to borrow someone's email list and get them to promote your offer. So what you could do is you could sign up to this platform known as Udemy.com, and then you click on the option up here that says Find Sellers. And this is going to bring up a list of people that have email lists, you know, in, you know, whatever specific niche. So, you know, anything about marketing, finance, health, mobile, social, and crypto. You could target any one of these different types of niches, and then you could pay one of these vendors to promote your offer. So, for example, let's say, for example, that I want to, you know, buy clicks from, you know, like this guy right here, Damien Verhagen. I can click on his name right here. And this right here, when I click on this, if it wants to bring that up, it shows he's charging 64 cents per visitor, and shows 36% of his buyers have actually reported to getting sales with his traffic. So in this case, You could buy anywhere from 100 visitors all the way up to, it looks like in this case, it's like, if this thing wants to even work here, it would be up to like 400 visitors. So this is the maximum that you could buy from this vendor. And right here is where you would include your link that you want to promote. So in this case, you know, I have, you know, a link from, you know, an old program that I was in. And then, you know, in this case, of course, you know, the amount of clicks you buy, of course, depends on, you know, how much you, of course, pay. So in this case, for 400 visitors, it would cost me about $259. And the benefit with this type of traffic is that it's some of the fastest traffic that you can get very quickly. So usually within 24 hours or so, or within like a few hours, you could have 400 people that are interested in what you have to promote over to your link. So that's traffic that you're getting very quickly. And you could also look at some of the reviews that he has. So a lot of people are reporting, okay, great run and great services. We'll continue to do business with Damien. 28% opt-in, 3 sales. Thank you. So in this case, if someone has lots of, you know, members showing that they have gotten sales, then that's a great traffic vendor to, of course, test with. So there's Udemy.com. There's also another solo ad vendor known as Igor Solo Ads. And this guy is like known to be, you know, kind of like the king of solo ads is what he's been known for. So Igor K Fitz, he provides traffic, solo ad traffic with his email list right there. And you can pay him to get, you know, high quality traffic. And the thing with Igor Solo Ads is that his traffic is a bit more on the more pricey side, but that's because his students have actually gotten lots of results with his traffic. So this is, you know, the first method that you could use when it comes to getting traffic in. Before I actually move on to the next one, there's something very important that I want to go over. So rule of thumb is that when you are deciding to buy traffic, especially if you're, you know, if you're paying for traffic, it's always important that you send traffic over to a capture page, or this is also known as an opt-in page. So the mistake that a lot of people make is that, okay, when they find a product that they want to promote, they think, okay, I'm just going to get a bunch of clicks over to my affiliate link, and if I get enough people to click on my link, eventually I'll start making sales, right? Well, the problem with that is that you are getting in front of people that, you know, unless if they buy right away, then you're never going to make any money. So it's kind of like, you know, throwing money down the toilet. You might as well take whatever dollar bills you have in your wallet and, you know, use it as toilet paper. Okay, maybe I went a bit too far right there. But anyways, what you want to do is you want to send people to an opt-in page. And the reason why you want to do this is because here is where someone can learn more about what you, you know, have to promote. It has a headline at the top that says, you know, would you like to learn how to get six-pack abs? Would you like to learn how to lose weight? Would you like to learn how to make more money online? If so, enter your name and email down below. And then you could, of course, learn more. You know, they get taken to the bridge page where you could then introduce yourself and talk more about, you know, what it is that you have to offer. You could share a story. And as they do this, as they enter their name and email here, they get put on to your email list. So what happens here is when you are building up your email list, when people are requesting information from you and they give you their email address, you could then follow up with them over and over and over again. So let's say, for example, that you send, you know, you buy like 400 clicks from this guy right here off of Udemy. And let's say that none of those people buy. So immediately you are, you know, in the red, $259, right? Well, if you are building your email list and you're getting people to, of course, you know, request information, they're entering your, they're giving you their email address, you could then follow up with them over and over and over again. So what you could do is you could send them back to the offer at any point, and you know, you can, you know, get send out an email, get, you know, get them back to the offer. Or what you could do is you could even provide them with something like, you know, you could either share like a blog post with them, you could share a video where you pretty much, you know, share more tips that you've, of course, learned in that specific niche. And then as you're doing this, you're building up trust with your audience. And this way, they, of course, get to know, like, and trust you a lot more, which means that they're going to be much more, you know, likely to, of course, buy whatever product it is that you have. So this is something that I really just cannot stress enough. You always want to make sure that you are building your email list. Never, ever send people straight to an affiliate link, because your chances are you're going to be wasting money. So this is just the one thing that I wanted to kind of mention real quick. But let's move on to the next method, which is something known as Facebook pay-per-click. Now, if you aren't familiar with Facebook ads, which I'm sure you probably are, Facebook, of course, is the largest social media platform. And the benefit with their advertising platform is that there are tons of different types of ads you could do. And you could also get very targeted traffic very quickly. So what you could do is you could set up a Facebook ads account. And you could set up any, you know, ad in terms of, you know, if you want to get traffic to a link, you could do that. If you want to get engagement on a post, if you want to get video views, if you want to use, you know, video to, of course, you know, build up an audience that way, you could do that. You could also focus on lead generation. You can get people to reach out to you in Messenger, and you know, there's a whole bunch of other things you could do. And you could even target people based on their specific location, their interests, you know, groups that they liked. So if you have, you know, any product in any niche that you want to promote, then Facebook is a great platform to consider using. Now, the two downsides with Facebook ads is that the cost tends to go up quite a bit, you know, over the years. So, you know, within the last, you know, 2 to 3 years, it's gone up like, I think like 2 to 3 times as much as it, you know, used to be a few years ago. So that's kind of the downside, which means that, you know, it's kind of, you know, it's harder to, of course, you know, break even. But the other downside is that Facebook is a bit strict. So if you are promoting something in like, you know, the business niche, right? Facebook tends to be very strict where if you say the wrong thing, if you say something along the lines of, you know, if you make any income claims or for whatever reason, they could decide to shut your account down and then, you know, there goes your business. So for that reason, I would not recommend that you fully rely on a platform like Facebook. But nonetheless, it is still an option out there. And it's also really great for retargeting. So if you have an audience that has seen your capture page once and they didn't opt in, Facebook is a great option to use when it comes to getting in front of those people again. So that's what Facebook is all about. The next method is with Google search traffic. Now, we have both Google Ads, and then there's also, of course, Microsoft Bing Ads that you could use. And what's really great about these platforms is that you could target people based on something that they are searching for. So if someone decides to go on Google, for example, and they search up, you know, how to lose belly fat naturally, right? This is a search phrase that is getting searched up to 33,000 times or, you know, even more than that per month. And it shows the competition is very low and the cost per click is about $1.07 per click. So what you could do is you could target this keyword if you're in the health niche, for example, and then you could have an ad be displayed right up top here. So notice how this says ad right up here. And this is, you know, an offer, some sort of workout program that they're of course promoting. So how to lose belly fat naturally, effective and free programs. So the best way to lose belly fat, you know, done at home without exercise. And you could have an ad go out pretty much right there in front of people who are searching for that. So really think about that for a minute. If you have people that are searching up how to get X result, or you know, how to lose weight, or how to, you know, get six pack abs, right? These are people that are very interested, very targeted, and very interested in, of course, getting that specific result. So that's why platforms like Google Ads and Bing Ads are very powerful platforms to, of course, use, because you can get in front of people who are searching up something very specific, and then if you have an offer that is, of course, you know, people, those people would be interested in, this is a great way to get lots of highly targeted traffic very quickly to your offer. So that is Google and Bing right there. Another method you could use is using influencers. Now, there's a site here called Upfluence.com, and there's a few other sites that are similar to this that I could have shown, like iFluence, I know, is another site. There's, you know, a few other ones as well, but Upfluence is the one that I really like the best, because you could actually pay any influencer on any of these platforms like Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, Twitter, Pinterest, TikTok, I guess, is blowing up as well, so there's tons of influencers on there. And then there's also bloggers. So what you could do is you could find any influencer on any social media platform, because, you know, there's influencers everywhere nowadays, and you could find any influencer who is, you know, let's say, for example, they are posting about, you know, getting into better shape, or they're posting about luxury or travel or, you know, crypto. You could find any influencer in your niche, and then you could pay them a specific amount to get your message in front of their audience. So if you have an offer that is, you know, say in the crypto niche, right? What you could do is you could find an influencer on any of these platforms to, you know, you could pay them a specific amount to get your message out there in front of your audience. So this could be anything in the form of a post on Instagram, it could be a video on YouTube, it could be, you know, something on Facebook or Pinterest or any of these other platforms. And then what you could do is you could have them promote your link that you want to promote in front of their audience. And if they are interested in that specific product, then you could, of course, you know, get that in front of them, and then they'll, of course, be willing to check out your offer. So this is one of the fastest ways of getting traffic. I'd say this is very similar to solo ads in the case of, you know, you are renting out someone else's audience, except in this case, instead of renting out their email list, you are getting in front of their audience on social media. So Upfluence is a very underutilized platform that not many people are talking about, and influencers, it is known to be a very powerful method to get your message out there and promote, you know, your offer there. So I would definitely look into Upfluence.com. But another method is with banner ads. Now, there's a platform here known as AdsTerra.com, And this is a platform you could use to set up a banner ad. Now, a banner ad is, of course, when you go to a certain website, like a blog, for example, and they have like a banner displayed on like the, you know, the right little widget there, and it has like a graphic, you know, showing, you know, would you like to grow an online business? Would you like to get six-pack abs? And I know I'm using that example quite a lot, but, you know, click here, and it's like a, some sort of like flashy image. And if someone, of course, clicks on that image, then you can get lots of targeted traffic really quickly there. Now, the benefit with banner ads is that this is a very, very cheap, very inexpensive traffic source that you could actually tap into, and you could target people based on websites that they visited, you know, search phrases that they looked up, you know, if they have been, you know, on your offer before. Like, let's say, for example, you've gotten people to a capture page and they didn't exactly, you know, request more information. This is a way that you could actually get in front of them again, and it's known to be very powerful. So this, you know, to give you an idea, you know, it shows exactly, you know, what the ad would look like. If we go to display banners right here, it would be like a banner right here. So it has your image right there, you know, in this exact size, and there's also one here you can get. And by the way, you could either choose to create banners yourself, or what you could do is you can go to a site like Fiverr.com and you could actually pay someone to create one for you. So, you know, if you aren't necessarily good with creating ads, what you could do is you can go to a site like Fiverr.com, and then you, right here under where it says graphics and design, you want to click on this option right here that says banner ads. And when you click on this option, this will bring up a list of people that will be willing to design a banner ad for you for anywhere from like, look, $20, $80, $15. And these banners right here, they look very good. So, you know, for example, you know, here we've got some examples of, you know, different banners that they've made. So here's one about like a, you know, like a certain wristwatch that measures, you know, walking and stuff like that. So to get an idea, I mean, you could just look through each of these different listings right here, and then you could pay one of these guys, one of these designers, to create a banner ad for you. Now, the one thing that I want to mention is that these people are designers. They are not marketers. So you have to be specific and tell them exactly what it is that you're looking for. So if you're promoting something in the make money online niche, or the, you know, the business niche, you want to specify, okay, this is what I want the ad to say. I want to use this image. You could have an image of yourself on there if you want to. You could even use like a graphic image. But, you know, whatever the case is, you want to communicate with them and let them know exactly what it is that you're, of course, looking for. So when they create that banner for you, you could then go to adsterra.com, and you could then pay to set up a banner ad and have it displayed on different websites that your customers, your potential customers, are visiting. So those are just a few of the different ways when it comes to getting traffic to your offer. These are primarily paid advertising methods that I wanted to go over, but I want to, of course, talk more about why is it that most people fail online? What is that missing ingredient that most people fail online? So what I want to do right now is I want to ask you a question, and I want you to let me know in the comments. This is going to be the question of the day. Out of these platforms right here, you've got Facebook, you've got Instagram, you've got YouTube, and then you've also got Google. Out of these four platforms right here, which platform do you spend the most time on? I don't know about you, but for me personally, it was YouTube. This was the platform right here that I was always spent a lot of time on. This was kind of like known as like my internet routine, where I would spend a lot of my free time on YouTube. This was even like before I got into this whole online marketing stuff. I would spend lots of time on YouTube, and I would watch a ton of videos. So whatever platform it is that you spend lots of your time on, what you want to do is you want to focus on building up an audience. And this right here is what most people are missing in terms of why they're, of course, failing. And what I want you to do specifically is, you know, whatever it is that you're currently in right now, you might be in a network marketing opportunity, you might be in some sort of high ticket affiliate program, whatever it is that you're looking to promote, I want you to try something. Try going to the leaderboard section in that specific program that you're in and see exactly who the top earners are. You know, look at, you know, the top five people that are making the most money, and try looking up each of their names on Facebook, Google, YouTube, and see if you could find something. Because oftentimes what you'll notice is that a lot of these top earners, what they have is they have a following built up. And this right here is the very thing that most people are missing. So in my case, for example, I mentioned earlier that, you know, when I first got into this stuff, I was buying lots of traffic. You know, every week I would spend, you know, $50 or, you know, like $100 on a solo ad every single week. And I was always depending on that specific traffic to, you know, generate me a profit. But the problem was, is that I was getting in front of people that didn't know who I was. And that's also the issue with a lot of these other methods too. You know, these methods are good, You can get lots of very highly targeted traffic, you know, very quickly. But even if you are going the paid traffic route, even if you have a massive budget to, you know, use when it comes to paid advertising, you still have to, of course, build up that connection with your audience. So if you're getting in front of people who don't know who you are and they don't necessarily trust you, they're never going to buy anything that you recommend. So this is why you really want to focus on building up an audience. And I recommend starting with one of these four core platforms. So when I started focusing on this, you know, I started focusing on building up a YouTube channel. And this was something that I started, you know, last summer, so like almost a year ago from the time that I'm filming this. And it was the consistency with this that allowed me to start generating commissions just like this. So this is what's allowed me to generate my first commissions of, you know, $376 a day, you know, $288 a day, $143 a day, you know, $85 a day. And these sales all came as a result of me starting my YouTube channel and sharing things that I was learning in my specific niche. So what I would do is with each of these videos, I would, you know, share something that I've learned. And then in my video descriptions, I would then have links to different programs and services that I would recommend. So if you are looking to build up an audience on YouTube, if you want to learn how to build a profitable YouTube channel, what you could do is you could check out my training down here, so which says right here, grow a profitable YouTube channel without showing your face. When you click on this link right here, it's going to take you over to a page that will show you how to make a full-time passive income on YouTube without filming yourself. So even if you don't feel comfortable on camera, even if you aren't, you know, the best when it comes to, you know, even if you're camera shy and you don't feel comfortable even recording your voice, this is a training worth checking out. And this is coming from someone who has bought into, you know, 5+ different YouTube courses. I've gone through a lot of different YouTube training programs because I really wanted to do everything that I could to learn everything that I could about YouTube. I really wanted to master YouTube, and I bought into a lot of different YouTube programs in the past, and most of them, unfortunately, are complete garbage. They teach the same stuff that, you know, doesn't really work as well today as it did, you know, a few years ago. But this strategy right here helps you to really build up your audience very quickly. It shows you how to go from 0 to 1,000 subscribers in the shortest amount of time possible, how to make viral videos with your voice in 15 minutes without showing your face, and how to find affiliate products that sell themselves, and how to quickly attract buyers without doing keyword research. So if you're interested in growing a following on YouTube and you really want to take the less riskier approach of, you know, not having to spend money on ads, and you want to get more high quality traffic, then this is a training that I would definitely recommend looking into. So all you have to do is click on reserve my seat now, and then you select your time that you'd be available to attend. Now, that being said, let's say that you aren't necessarily good when it comes to YouTube, and let's say that you would prefer to build your audience elsewhere. Like if you want to build up an audience on Facebook, for example, or on Instagram or with Google, what you could do is you could also check out my free book, which is the Traffic Secrets book right here. And I even did a review of this recently, as you can see right here, but that is this book right here. And in the link down below, I'll also have a link to where you could pick up the free copy of Traffic Secrets. So if you want to get this book for free, all you have to do is click on that link. And then from here, all you'll have to do is pay for shipping. So you would watch this video right here, and then you pay the shipping, which is like around, you know, 10 bucks, which is pretty much nothing right there. And if you are someone that is really looking to build an audience, this book is definitely a great place to start, because, you know, there's a lot of other, you know, training programs out there about how to do paid traffic. But the problem is with a lot of them is that if you're someone who's completely brand new, you might not have a budget to spend on paid advertising. And also the quality of traffic that you're getting isn't necessarily the best. So the thing that I really love about this book is that Russell Brunson, the author, really focuses on, if you're someone who's completely brand new, he really encourages you to build up an audience. And he goes over exactly how to do all that stuff step by step. So whatever it is that you're looking to build up an audience on, then this book is definitely one that I highly recommend checking out. But anyways, hope you got lots of value in this video. If you did, be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Give this a thumbs up if you got lots of value. And anyways, take care.